Hi Tasha, can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, great. I think it's logged in from my personal ID, but that's fine. As long as you
That's
can hear.
okay. Absolutely, absolutely. You're quite
Awesome.
touch wood. I hope this goes on well because I
This is
think
better now.
you're quite
It's
audible.
clear. Okay, great.
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, great.
So it was
So
actually just going, back and forth, but now I think it's a good thing that, you're quite audible.
Sure, great. So I'll introduce myself again, just to the audience. My name is Ali Rashid, and I'm a director at the Jhanuma Group of Hotels. And we started in 1983 through Jhanuma Palace. That was a hotel and a company founded by my father and his brother. So both of them converted an ancestral property into a palace hotel, which is now obviously running till date. And slowly, in 2009-10, we ventured into safari tourism with Renipani Jungle Lodge, which is located in Satpura Tiger Reserve. And then in 2013, we moved on to a property called Jhanuma Retreat, which is in Bhopal, just on the outskirts of Bhopal. It's a 12-acre farmland which we had inherited. And it's a 28-room boutique property where we do a lot of kitchen gardening, and it's more on wellness and a farm-to-table sort of concept. And finally, very recently, just 2 weeks before the lockdown, we started the Bori Safari Lodge, which pretty much was operational for 2 to 3 weeks before the lockdown,
Sure.
came about. Additionally, we also have a bakery retail in the city of Bhopal itself. So as a group, we are purely into hospitality, and our major business is hotels, particularly in central India, in Bhopal and in the Satpura National Park.
Right. Right.
So that's a brief intro.
Sure. So now that we've been hearing that the hospitality section per se would open from the 8th of June.
Correct. 8th of June, I mean, there's some talks. Sorry, you were saying something?
So that's what I was saying, that I don't know how true is it, but what exactly do you feel the changes would be, pre-COVID and post-COVID? Or I mean, COVID is still very much there,
Correct.
but So share some,
So obviously, through the central government announcements, the date has been outlined for 8th of June, but they've also given the states and the districts the authority to change that. So basically, Madhya Pradesh still hasn't clearly announced, but
Right.
even whenever that happens, our city hotels will definitely open as per the government guideline, with a lot of SOPs in place and keeping it as safe for the guests as possible. Both
Right.
Jhanuma Palace and Jhanuma Retreat, we will obviously follow all the safety guidelines that are outlined by the government. As far as the jungle lodges are concerned, it's going to take longer, because now this is pretty much the end of the season. Usually we close down 15th June anyway, because the monsoon, the park
Right.
is closed. So now, even if any announcement happens, it doesn't matter. We already started to wrap up the lodge, and we are kind of hoping to reopen in October if the conditions are suitable and if it's safe to open. But again, obviously the safety norms will be followed. In a jungle lodge property, because for example, Renipani is spread over 35 acres of land, and we only have 16 rooms, 12 cottages
Right.
and 4 tents. So these are anyway spaced out and far off, enabling social distancing. The dining areas are big, the spaces are big, the activities that we do, like walks into the park and the safaris, are also something which has social distance inbuilt. So in that sense, all our staff, in fact, stay on the property itself. So it's kind of
Right.
isolated. So in fact, the challenge we will face when we reopen will be to actually convince the local staff who are in COVID-free areas, because these are all remote locations and there's no COVID case there. So it will be to make them confident that the guests who are coming from cities which have quite a few COVID cases are actually safe. So that is the challenge we will face actually more than the other way around.
Right. So why don't you tell us more about the Satpura, and then we would want to know more about your lodges also there.
So Satpura is a tiger reserve. It's the largest tiger reserve in the state of Madhya Pradesh. And Satpura National Park, along with Bori Sanctuary and Pachmari Sanctuary, make up this whole landscape, which is completely forested. We have close to about 45 tigers here, but the what we try to showcase here is not just the tiger. We have so many different animals like the sloth bear, the leopard, the wild dogs, and several other bird species, and mammals as well. And we also have a range of activities. So typically when you go to a safari park, you would be in a jeep. But here in Satpura, right, you can walk. There's a big reservoir over there, so you can do canoeing and boating activities on the river. We also do some interesting camping programs that we do. And Reni Pani has been in the forefront of promoting tourism here for the last 10 years. Recently, as I mentioned in my introduction, we also opened Bori Safari Lodge, which is on the southern side of the same park, but you'll be exploring different areas. So it could be a good, you could spend two nights at Reni Pani, two nights at Bori. Bori has a different landscape. It's slightly flatter terrain compared to Satpura, which is quite hilly and undulating. And both the places offer something different, because Satpura, as I said, you have a lot of the different activities. In Bori, there's a chance of seeing tiger more than Satpura. So if you combine the two places, then you can get the diversity of activities. You can see the sloth bear, you can see the leopard, the wild dogs, and towards the Bori side have a good chance of seeing tiger as well. And the unique thing is, between the two places, you can either transfer through the park, so you don't need to do a highway transfer. You can do a full day safari and transfer through the park, or you can do a boat ride on the Tawa River, which is skirting the national park, and then you could come to the Bori Lodge. So there's quite a few options and quite a lot of interesting experiences for the guests in this area.
Tips, what people should keep in their mind?
Sorry, your voice was cracking.
Okay, so I'm saying, would you want to share some tips as to when people plan their safari, during what period in time, or what kind of preparations, or because sunset, and I mean, that is the time when generally people say that most of the animals are seen coming to have water. It's
correct,
either early
correct.
Morning
so
or
actually,
it's, yeah.
So it depends on what you're looking for. Actually, the forest is amazing throughout the year, but typically for tourists, I think the best time to come is starting mid-October, right until around mid-April. So that's when you, especially on the northern side where Reni Pani is, because I said there's a river, and which is also a dam, so they use the water for irrigation. So as the dry season comes, the water level starts dropping. But if you come from October to February, March, you get the option of doing there's enough water for you to do the boat safaris. The weather is nice, so the walking safaris are good. The jeep allows you to see different mammals like the sloth bear and leopard, etc. So October to April would be a good time to come, both in Satpura and in Bori. And as you were mentioning earlier, obviously safaris are best done early morning, or late evening. And that's what we, try to do. Guests would typically leave early morning from the lodge, go for a half day safari, come back to the lodge by around 11:30, then break for lunch. And then after lunch, do another safari or whatever activity you would like to do.
Right. And is it any precautions once a person sights a tiger? people generally tend to feel either very, you know, they tend to be very excited.
Yeah, so, you know, one of the major focuses of ours is on well-trained naturalists. So each guest actually goes with a naturalist. We don't send a guest for a safari without a naturalist. And they are trained
right
on the different behavior of the animals that you find in the national park, whether you're on a walk or you're on a canoe safari or you're on a jeep safari. These people will be interpreting the wildlife for you and also obviously making sure that the guests are behaving in a responsible way when they see these animals. Talking about walks, you know, we go walking in areas where there is a chance of seeing big mammals, but the focus of the walk is more to do with smaller things because jeep safaris are the best to see tigers, leopards, sloth bears, etc. But on the walk, your focus would be to see the trees, to see the birds, to see different small things which you miss out, you know, footprints of the pug marks of the animals, these sort of things which you miss out on the jeep. So the naturalists will be leading the activity and they don't take any unnecessary risks if they know that there's an animal around, especially a dangerous animal. Then we would typically not follow it, and we would only follow if it's, you know, if they recognize that it's safe. So, you know, that's the thing. So that way we can control the way the guests behave during these, you know, sightings.
Sometimes has something, I mean, I do not know about your lodges, but I have heard there are some cases where they can actually sight a tiger sitting right outside their lodge also.
Yeah, so our lodge, the Reni Pani Lodge, which is at the Satpura National Park, we are in a forested habitat. So we have quite a lot of wildlife coming to the property itself. We still haven't had tiger coming, but apart from tiger, we've had leopard, which you see. In fact, I just spoke to Irvin, who's our manager at the lodge. In the morning at 5:30, there was a leopard which was in the property. They are still there. Because when the lockdown started, some of the team members were still there. So there was a leopard this morning. And as we speak, during the lockdown, there's been wild dogs which have been coming in. We have a resident herd of deer, about 30 spotted deer, which live in the property itself. Wild boar, which live there. Sloth bear keeps coming in and out. So we have a lot of wildlife coming into the property. Still haven't had tiger because that area the where the lodge is not... the tiger density is not so high, but apart from tiger, every other animal and bird has been frequenting the property.
And what, I mean, how is it safe if, you know, if a person is visiting your property and, you know, you've got leopards and the other animals?
Yeah, so
what precautions you take?
Yeah, so these animals actually, they don't come, as I said, you know, every day. First of all, these animals are quite shy, so they avoid humans.
Sure.
Only if you're lucky enough, you would see them in the property. It's something that happens. In fact, even when they come, usually you wouldn't, like this morning also, our manager and naturalist, they didn't see the leopard. They only heard the alarm calls. When the leopard is moving in the forest, you would have animals like spotted deer, like monkeys making alarm calls. So we know that the leopard is there. And they saw the footprints. But the leopard itself will try to stay away from human activity. So these animals itself are shy and will stay away. But the precautions we take is, you know, usually because we are in the buffer zone, there's animals are mostly nocturnal because of the human activity over here. So at night, our staff escort the guests to and from the rooms. You know,
right.
In the daytime, it's quite safe. You can roam around. Our rooms are also quite secure. So that way, you know, the thing about wildlife is if you keep your distance from them and if you respect their space, then they will not attack unprovoked. So that way, we've never had a case like that. But we definitely escort the guests to and from the rooms.
Right, right. And would you want to share one of your experiences now that, you know in and out of the entire place?
Yeah.
So any of your experience that you would want to share with us?
I mean, the thing is, because I've pretty much lived there for the last 10 years, and now with my family and the kids, I'm between Bhopal and Satpura. But pretty much for the last 10 years, I've spent a lot of time there. So I've had quite a lot of experiences with wildlife, but one of the instances which is still which was quite exciting was when I encountered a sloth bear with its cubs in on foot, and we were actually in the buffer zone, and someone had just crossed. There was a seasonal stream, like a nala, running through the
Right.
forest, where there's water which gets left behind in the summer months. So a person
Right.
kind of a local person who was on a bike saw the sloth bear crossing the road, and he came and told us that there's a sloth bear in that particular nala. So we went to see it. At that time my brother was also there, the lord, so both of us went. And from the road, the place where the water is, you can't see from the road. So we had a look, and we couldn't see the bear, so we thought it had gone. So we thought we'll go check out the water hole itself to see if there's anything else.
Right.
And there's a blind turn
Right.
towards the water also. As we took that turn, the bear was in a blind spot which we couldn't see from the other spots except for when we reached. And she was pretty much just about 20 feet, less than 20 feet away. And both the bear and the cubs and us were quite startled. And luckily it was just a peaceful encounter, but that experience was something which I still remember.
Absolutely. Well, listening to your story only makes us quite intrigued.
Yeah, and usually sloth bears are quite protective of their young, so that was the slightly scary part, that the mother was with the young
Right.
one. Usually they wouldn't attack, but sometimes with the young ones they could, like any it's true with humans also, mothers are protective of their young ones, and
Absolutely.
that's what animals also do. So that's what we need to be aware of.
That's nice. That's nice. That's nice. And I mean, actually, I can ask you so many questions about the lodge. So I think I will also move towards your Bhopal property.
Sure, yeah. So just to tell you a bit about the Janma Palace, as I mentioned earlier, it was started in 1983, and it
Yeah.
started as a small property, just 14 rooms. And this building was built by my great-grandfather. So our family happens to be descendants of the royal family of Bhopal. And the main palace of Bhopal is in the old city. But in the early 20th century, there was a plague in the city, and the three brothers who were the, in fact, Bhopal was ruled by three begums before the last
Right.
Nawab was there. So the last begum had three sons, and the three sons, they all moved to different parts, slightly out of the city. So my great grandfather moved to Shamla Hill, where our current hotel is, and he built
Right.
this property here. And another, and we all started to live here, and slowly, I mean, as generation went down, my father and his brother decided to convert this family legacy and inherited property into a hotel. And as I said, we started with 14 rooms, and slowly we grew that, and now it's become quite a big establishment. We have almost 100 rooms at the property, where we have a mix of corporate and leisure tourists. But one of the key things that we focus on is obviously the experience. We also have a history of breeding horses, so we have a small horse track which is in the property, where our two riders, they work the out. So when you wake up in the morning, you have horses running on a track, which is a very interesting experience. We also focus, Janma is well known for its food, and especially the
Sure.
Indian restaurant called Under the Mango Tree. We have a lot of
Right.
signature dishes where these are all, typical, they're not typical restaurant items. These are all home recipes which have been passed down generations from our households. In fact, a lot of the chefs, apart from the standard restaurant dishes that they offer, for the signature dishes, they come to our house, and we actually, our home cooks still teach them all the recipes. And then obviously moving to the Janma Retreat, which we started in 2013. As I mentioned, that we used to breed horses for horse racing in Bombay, and this was a
Right.
farmland where we grew the fodder for the horses. And once we then eventually stopped breeding horses, so we thought that we could use this property, keep the ethos of the farming going, because that is a nice concept, and have a small sustainable hotel, just 28 rooms, but maintain the farming over there. So we have a lot of vegetables growing there, a lot of herbs growing there, a lot of spices,
right.
And we try to maximize, you know, whatever is cooked in the kitchen from the land itself, you know. And this is mostly a leisure property, so most of the people who come on holidays to Bhopal, we try to recommend both. Obviously, Palace has a history behind it, but this also has a different charm, and it's very green, and neighboring is this place called Van Vihar, which is a city national park in Bhopal itself, which is about you know, a large area where you have greenery. Guests can go for walks over there, they can cycle over there,
right.
And you know, so these two properties have come out quite well. Now coming to Bhopal as a destination, which I think your viewers and you would also be interested in learning about. So Bhopal is not generally seen as a tourist destination, but you know, it's a lovely city. It's a city of lakes. So we've got over 7-8 lakes, which are, you know, very interesting to see. The city itself is a green city. Both the cities of Madhya Pradesh, Indore and Bhopal. Indore is ranked consistently as the cleanest city in India, and Bhopal ranks second,
yeah,
for 2-3 consecutive surveys. And there's a lot of history in the city, right from Raja Bhoj, who made the Bhopal Lake in the 11th to 12th century, with the Bhojpur Temple and influences of that sort of architecture, to more recently, which I had mentioned, the Begums of Bhopal, where there's the influence of some Muslim architecture
right.
as well. So there's a good blend of, you know, two different cultures, Hindu architecture and Muslim architecture, fusing into the city of Bhopal. We've got one of the largest mosques, you know, in the country. We've got state-of-the-art museum. The government has just launched about in the last 5 years a tribal museum, which is a must-do for anyone visiting Bhopal. We've got the National Museum of Man. Again, it invites people from all over the country. So there's people, all indigenous and tribal communities from all over the country have built their houses within this complex. So it's very interesting to
right.
see different cultures coming to this Museum of Man and showcasing how their lives are in different parts of the country. There's a lot of culture in Bhopal with the, you know, Bharat Bhavan, which is a cultural center. And within half an hour to 1 hour of the city, we've got Sachi, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and a Buddhist stupa, one of the most important stupas in India.
Right.
And on the way to Satpura from Bhopal, you've got Bhimbetka, which is age-old rock paintings, you know, dating back to 10,000 years. So, you know, and obviously there's certain forts in and around half an hour from Bhopal, Islam Nagar, Bhojpur Temple. So I'm just naming some of the attractions, and it's actually untouched and unspoiled spots which travelers can explore, you know. And I think post-COVID also, there will be a theme of visiting new places rather than going back to the crowded, you know, general tourist spots, you know, the kind of golden triangle that we are used to. And Bhopal gives
right.
a refreshing change. Where there's a lot of history, you know, and the way we do it also, we've got an in-house historian who actually takes our guests for history walks and showcases all these, you know, monuments, all these cultural centers to the guests. So it's definitely something worth visiting, you know, and Bhopal needs to be showcased a little more as a travel destination.
So we have this question here. How are you preparing, you know, how are you preparing your properties post-COVID?
Yeah, so, you know, as we were discussing a little earlier, our city hotels are possibly going to open earlier. The general sense is that, you know, 8th June is when the hotels are going to start. But Madhya Pradesh, we haven't announced anything clearly yet. So first of all, we are just waiting for the guideline to come out from the state government and the district administration. But already we've created a comprehensive, SOP for both the hotels in Bhopal, Jhanuma Palace and Jhanuma Retreat. So we've covered all the departments there, right from guest check-in to having a, seamless, maybe contactless check-in as well, and keeping the hygiene standards up in the kitchens, in the rooms. Try to minimize the housekeeping, so that there's less contact between, the staff and the guests. So, whatever the standard SOPs we are seeing going around, definitely we are going to implement it to the strictest norms. But we still have to just wait and watch, and things are changing every day. So we will have to adapt. This is an evolving document that we've made, and we will keep incorporating the best guideline. As far as our jungle lodges are concerned, I don't see them opening before October. Okay. So we haven't yet, because off season, the park is closed in the monsoon month. So we haven't yet come up with a pre-opening plan, because October is still quite some time away. And if we have something in place now, it might not be true in October, but generally a jungle lodge like Rainy Pani is spread in 35 acres. Bori Safari Lodge is smaller, but in 7.5 acres. And Bori Safari Lodge has only 8 rooms, Rainy Pani only 16. So the rooms are spread out. Naturally, people are actually at a social distance. We have big right. dining spaces, so we can have isolated private dining experiences for guests. At Bori, what we are thinking also is that it's an 8-room property. So known people, once we open, so if there's a family of 3 to 4 people who know each other, and we know that... first of all, we'll try to only sell to people who we know, so our repeat clients right. to start off with. So when we know that right. these people are responsible and safe, we would maybe give the whole property of 8 rooms just to 3-4 families. That would make it safe for them, and that would make it safe for our staff also. All our staff also live on the campus, so basically they are isolated as it is. And our jungle lodges are all in COVID-free areas. So as I was mentioning earlier also, that the challenge we will face in those places will be to actually sensitize our staff and make them feel right. safe, because people will be coming in from the city who could be carriers, and these people are actually, our staff are people who are in COVID-free zones, living on the property and being isolated anyway, So that's what, it's a bit of wait and watch to see how it unfolds.
Right. And would there be a special training program for these, for your staff?
Yeah, definitely. So in our Bhopal hotels, we've already created these SOPs, and people are at home, but we are doing all these Zoom calls and these sort of platforms we are using, similar to Zoom, to train the staff. So all the different department heads are coming on board and then teaching their people. So this we started almost over a month ago for our Bhopal hotel. Even our jungle right. lodges, they've joined in to get awareness. First of all, we made people aware of all the facts of COVID before going into the SOPs, because there's so much fake news also going on and people are so scared also. So we first yeah. did confidence building in the facts and figures about COVID, and how anyway in India it is increasing, but still our per person rate is quite low. If you see... per people in terms of the number of people who have COVID in lakh, it's very less compared to many countries. So these sort of facts and figures we gave the staff so that they would be confident first, and then we started right. rolling out the SOP plan through online, online communication software. So all that right. has already started.
And how far is your property from the airport? This was also a question which I read.
Yeah. So Jhanuma Palace and Jhanuma Retreat are just about 25 minutes from the airport, both. Maybe Retreat is 30 minutes, but not more. And the jungle lodges are 3.5 hours. So Rainy Pani is 3.5 hours away from Bhopal. Bori Safari Lodge is 3.5 hours away from Bhopal and from Nagpur. So it's almost in the midpoint of Bhopal and Nagpur. So both places okay. can be used to connect to Bori Safari Lodge.
And there's another question which I'm reading out. How will it shape up on the business front for Genuma as a brand, as people might travel more domestically post-COVID?
Yeah, so again, we need to wait and watch, because we're hearing a lot of these things that domestic will start and people will do driving holidays first.
Yeah.
You know, but again, Jahanuma Palace and Retreat, we have a good mix of domestic. In fact, we have more domestic in these two properties compared to inbound. Raini Pani, we have a good mix of both international and domestic. So we have about almost 55-60% inbound and 40% domestic. So now, obviously, in our Jungle Lodge, we will have to focus more on domestic, at least for the next 12 months. But again, you know, if someone is coming from Delhi or Bombay, they will have to take a flight. And if there's all these norms, Madhya Pradesh doesn't have this quarantine issue right now, but most of the states have like either a home quarantine or institutional quarantine. So it's very difficult for a leisure traveler to travel to a destination when they have to be quarantined for 14 days, you know. So
right.
That is something, only once all these things open up, only once these things change and once it's safe for people to travel, or when, a vaccine is out, that's when I
right.
foresee leisure travel starting, you know. So that is the thing. So it's difficult to say how business will be, how it will affect the business. Right now, in fact, there's no business. The main thing is how it will pick up, that
yeah.
we'll see as it unfolds.
And coming to the rates, you know, so like, I mean, we all know that, you know, the entire world is suffering right now. So once
yeah.
the hospitality opens up, would you be slashing down the rates, or the rates would be going up, or would you be doing some special, some catchy, what, you know, basically the hotels have been doing. So they've been sharing some catchy rates also.
Correct. So I think we'll have to have a different strategy, because our hotels have a different nature.
Right.
The Bhopal hotels will probably have a different strategy. But,
right.
know, we try to focus more on, quality experiences. So we won't be slashing rates as much. We will be trying to invite the guests maybe through a flexible model where people can pay, in advance and have flexible dates in case the conditions change. So in that effect, we'll be quite flexible where dates can change because of the
sure.
dynamic situation. But we won't, I don't think we'll slash the rates. Same with the Jungle Lodges, because it's heavy on experience, and usually our plan is like an all-inclusive plan where we include the safaris and the naturalist goes with the guests. We try to source things locally. We try to, our focus is to employ local people, even though it's more difficult to train them, but so that the local communities benefit. So, and because
nice.
The inventory is small, Bori Safari Lodge is 8 rooms and Raini Pani 16 rooms. So because the inventory is small, so usually our motto is to have a low volume but high quality quotient. So it's very difficult to operate at low rates. So we will be sticking to what we do best, and let's hope
sure.
That people can come to us soon.
I completely agree with you, because travel is what we generally live for.
Correct.
Right.
Yeah, and
so,
just to add,
yeah.
yeah, sorry, just to add that this is now a good circuit also, which we were talking about. You were talking about domestic, and now definitely there's a sense that many people who would travel outbound from India for a week or 10 days, they will not be traveling probably for the next 12 months. So there's a good opportunity for driving holidays, or flying, just doing one flight and then coming to Bhopal and then doing this mini circuit where you could do Bhopal for culture and then Raini Pani and Bori for wildlife. And we have places like Indore and Nagpur which are drivable. But even people who have 10 days on hand can drive from Delhi, take
right.
a stop at a nice hotel, then come to Bhopal. And similar from Bombay, if you drive from Bombay to a place called Maheshwar, It has a lovely hotel called Ahilya Fort, so people can stop there for 3 days. They also have a similar concept, just 18-19 rooms next to the Narmada River, very experiential, you know. And then that is a 7-8 hour drive or 8 hour drive from Bombay, slightly long drive, but those people who enjoy driving can do that and then stop there, then come to Bhopal, see the culture, then go to Satpura. So people who have a longer duration, especially the outbound travelers who used to anyway spend 10 days or 12 days going overseas, can now start using a domestic circuit till the international travel really opens up.
That's true.
Yeah.
And how far is your, when we talk about your two properties which are there, the Satpura, so how far are they from each other? I mean, how much time does it take to drive down?
So, from Bhopal, as I mentioned, is 3.5 hours to Renipani, and Bori Safari Lodge is 3.5 hours from both Nagpur and Bhopal. Now, between the two properties, there's 2-3 ways of doing it. What we recommend is actually to transfer from inside the park itself. So, for example, if someone stays 2 nights at Renipani first, then they would do 2 nights of activities, safaris, and then on the third day, they would either take a full day safari where we take packed lunch and all that, and they would drive through the park. You know, they would do a safari till about 12 noon, and then they would rest at a forest rest house for 2 hours where we'd serve packed items and have some hot food also made at the forest rest house. And they would rest for a bit, and then at 2:33, they would again start doing an afternoon safari and then exit the park towards the Bori Sanctuary. So you would do a full day safari experience while traveling. So that would, you know, that would be a high quality experience, and you won't have to be on a highway and you won't have to be on a transfer vehicle. The other option is to actually do a boat transfer. So near Renipani side, there's a big river, Tawa. It's actually a dam, Tawa Dam. So this water body is quite big. And from the Renipani gate where you enter the park, you can actually book a boat and go towards the main dam structure of Tawa Dam, which is a 2.5 hour boat ride. Again, the naturalist will be guiding the guests on the birds that you're seeing, on the different landscape, and on the animals that would come down to the edge of the water. And there, once you reach the Tawa Dam, then you can be picked up by a vehicle and drive 1 hour to Bori Safari Lodge. So, that way you have an interesting option of transfers rather than choosing just being on a highway. If you go from outside, it takes about 3 hours. If you go from the highway, it takes about 2.5 to 3 hours to transfer from one lodge to the other lodge. But we wouldn't recommend that. With these other options are so much better, and you don't waste time. You're seeing wildlife, you're with a naturalist, you're having a picnic on the way. So it is an experience in itself moving from one place to the other rather than a drive on the highway.
Right. And when we talk about Bollywood, I mean, this is a favorite question, which I think I keep on getting a lot of, you know, PMs and people who want to know about Bollywood. So have you had any of your, in any of your properties, any of the Bollywood stars stayed, or any shooting has happened anywhere?
We haven't had shooting as such, but definitely in Bhopal, in the Bhopal hotels, because Madhya Pradesh is kind of promoting itself as a, you know, as a movie destination, as a film destination. So there have been actors who've come and stayed with us at Jhanuma Palace. Over the years, there's been quite a few actors. Embarrassingly enough, now I can't remember the names of all the actors who've come. But we did have, you know, in fact, we also had the crew of Hollywood movie staying here till recently, and they were shooting in Bhopal as well. They didn't reveal which movie they were shooting for. So right from Bollywood and Hollywood, both, because Madhya Pradesh as a state, the tourism department of Madhya Pradesh is inviting movies to be shot over here, because we have a lot of different, landscapes. We have forests, we have the city, we have monuments. So it's become a nice movie shooting destination. So in that way, we've had quite a lot of crew coming. At our Jungle Lodge, we've had some people like notable people like Rahul Dravid, the cricketer, has come and been our guests. We've recently had some actors also. So on and off, we do keep getting people people who are known to the public, especially actors who are coming.
Right.
And in fact, my wife itself, she is a singer, as a playback singer for Bollywood. She obviously lives at the lodge with me when I'm there, and lives in Bhopal. So we've anyway got a star amongst us itself.
Well, that's so nice. That's nice.
Yeah.
So and would you want to share something?
She's sung a few songs like Battameez Dil and Subah Hone Na De. These are the famous ones. So as a playback singer, of course, so usually the singer's voice is known, the face is not known so much.
So you have to tell us her name at least. I mean, we don't even know whom are we talking about.
Shefali Alvarez, her name is, yeah.
How nice.
You can like her on Instagram. So
absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
So
I don't know. I think I've asked you quite a bit of stuff. If in case you would want to share something which I have skipped.
No, I think we've covered most of the things pertaining to our hotels. And hopefully the viewers found this interesting. And we hope to see, we hope that, first of all, it becomes safe to travel, after which we'll be ready to host the guests in the safest possible way.
No, absolutely. Yeah. Those of you who've kind of joined us late, we'll be putting the story also on the Travel Jingles, on the story for next 24 hours. It will be available, so you could definitely check this out and have a lot of views what Ali has shared with us. So Ali, I think it was a fantastic session here today with you.
Thank you, Hitasha. Sorry for the bit of glitch in the beginning.
No, it's perfectly fine.
I've joined in from my personal account by mistake rather than the...
That's
the
okay. As long as you could have your views, that's perfectly fine.
Yeah. So I think the earphones work much better than the just talking, without
absolutely.
That. Absolutely. Yeah.
No, because you have the mic and everything attached, so it becomes very
correct.
Clear.
Correct.
Great. So I wish you all the best. And it was a lovely session here with you today.
Thank you for having me. It was a pleasure to have this conversation. And thank you once again.
Thank you so much. Thank you all the viewers. I hope you've enjoyed as much as we did. Wish you all the luck.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thanks
all
again.
All right. Bye-bye. Bye.